Hey there, superstars. It is Vanessa here again, your speaker, trainer, and coach from Live, Love, Give. And I'm coming to you. I'm just kind of on the back end of feeling like I'm about to lose my voice because I just spent a couple of hours with everybody in the monthly masterclasses with the Limitless Potential Academy. And I was kind of just getting fully in my zone with all things that we dive into. And I wanted to share a little bit about what we just went through in the masterclass. So the masterclass that we did this month was all on accessing your power, purpose, and potential through the eight vehicles of potential. And this work really came and was really honestly inspired by a four-day event that I did with Dr. John DeMartini. Back in January 2018, I went to his Master Planning for Life course, and I also did his Breakthrough Experience. And I've been wanting to share these, the value from this, from these two courses for a long time now, and I finally got the ability to do that. And I wanted to share a little piece of it with you guys to just give you a meta perspective on the value of identifying your highest values, which is really the key thing that Dr. John DeMartini is doing in all of his work. So the sun's gone down. I got some weird lighting going on, but let's dive into it before I lose my voice completely. It's like, itching. So today we want to talk about your highest values determine your purpose, power, and potential. And if you don't know what your highest values are, you're ultimately sacrificing all three. You're sacrificing your purpose, your power, and your potential. And I'm going to unpack and I'm going to let you guys know exactly how that kind of works out and what you can be doing instead. So at the end of the day, you know, your highest values, what you're most driven by as an individual, is how it really determines your access to your potential in every single realm. So whatever you're uniquely inspired by ends up being the gift that you have to give to the world. Now, Dr. DeMartini, I'm already struggling. We'll talk about how the Greeks would call your purpose in life your telos. And he believes that your number one value, the thing that you value over and above everything else, is ultimately your purpose. So, you know, we're all trying to search for our purpose and meaning in our lives. And, you know, what's my purpose is a big question in the personal development realm. And I love, love, love how DeMartini simplifies it down to what you value most as a human being. Because what you value most as a human being is the thing that you will push through the inevitable challenges with. You will go far and further and way beyond anybody else would do in that realm to become better and better and better at it because you're inspired by it. You know, you guys have heard me talk time and time again about the difference between inspiration and motivation. So what those are is we require motivation when it's not something that's in our values, when we need some sort of external source or force, you know, rewarding us and keeping us on track, and motivation isn't going to stand the test of time. Whereas when you tap into inspiration, that thing that really inspires you, what you really value, it's coming from within and you're spontaneously inspired to do it. Nobody has to tell you what to do. Nobody has to wake you up and get you on track. Nobody has to keep you accountable. And that's the thing that we want to tap into. Why do we want to do that? Because at the end of the day, if you're not growing at your highest capacity and you're not feeling a sense of contribution, like your life is making some sort of meaningful difference in the lives of others or many, then ultimately you are not living a fulfilling life and you're definitely not serving your purpose and reaching your potential. So it's really important to tap into our highest values and look at it this way. Look at it when we can go through a system, and there is a free system that I'm always pointing you guys to on Dr. John DeMartini's website. If you go to drdmartini.com and look at his values determination test, you can take a free test online. It's a really great piece of software. It'll allow you to answer a bunch of questions and come up with your hierarchy of values. And I can't stress enough just how important that is for you to tap into. And I'm going to explain a little bit more about why. But go and do that if you haven't already. I've got a process that I just delivered to everybody in the masterclasses, and I also have gone through values work with everybody in the 8-week empowerment program that I run. So I really am over this stuff. I really know the value of it, and that's why I'm wanting to articulate it in the best way I can for you guys. But if you're concerned about knowing what your purpose is in life and you want to make sure that you're living a fulfilling life free from regrets, then you absolutely must know what your hierarchy of values are. It is the clarity and direction that you need. All right. So when it comes to our power and our potential, right? So accessing your highest value and knowing that that's your purpose is going to allow you to access higher levels of your potential, right? Because as I said, when you do the things that matter to you most, that you value most, you're most inspired to break through the inevitable challenges and become the best at that thing, right? Whatever it is. And we've all got our unique way of looking at that and what that is for us. And then what we want to look at is there are these 8 different vehicles of your potential. And these vehicles can be looked at as the different areas of life you may refer to them as. And if any of them are struggling, you're not having health in any of them, they're draining the energy and the capacity that you have to really focus and direct into your highest value, your purpose, your genius, whatever you want to refer to it as. And so it's really important, and what this month's monthly masterclass is all about is looking at each of the 8 vehicles of your potential. So we dove deep into financial power, mental power, vocational or career power, your social or leadership skills in the community, your family or familial power, like how those relationships are, your intimate relationship power, your physical power, and your spiritual power. So each of these 8 vehicles of your potential or areas of life, if you want to look at it that way, if you don't have health in one or more of these, they become like energy drains away from you reaching your potential and accessing that genius, that purpose, whatever you're most authentically inspired by. And so if you don't create health and integrate the different areas of your life and, you know, at least create health and not be exceeding and mastering in each of these different 8 vehicles, then you're sacrificing your purpose, your power, and your potential. Okay, so highest values are really integrated. So when we look at your highest values, you're not going to be able to live fully in there and direct and channel your energy towards, you know, living your most inspired life if you've got any unhealthiness happening in those 8 areas of your potential or your life. So if you're struggling financially, if you are, you know, not creating mindfulness and looking after your internal world and tapping into your insightfulness, if you're, you know, struggling with your career and not knowing what you're going to do and where you're going with that and not being of service, if you are struggling socially and you know you're lacking friendship groups and meaningful connections and maybe even a community of like minds, or if you are really struggling in your relationships with your family members, or if you're either don't have or you're avoiding, or you've got a really challenging dynamic at play in your intimate relationship, or if your physical health is struggling and you're just not kicking goals there, or if you are not tapping into some greater purpose and meaning in your life, some attachment to something much bigger and grander than just yourself, then you are sacrificing your purpose, power, and potential, and you're not going to have the energy to direct towards your most inspired and authentically aligned life. So, number one, you've got to get clear on your highest values. I've just given you a free resource. Go check out drdmartini.com and go and do the values determination test. If you guys are in the masterclass and you couldn't make it live for what we just went through, the recording is just uploading on my computer right now. So it'll be up there very, very shortly for you so you can dive in and get the value from that. If you want to be a part of the masterclasses, you can click the link. You'll also get access to today's masterclass that's currently uploading, and you can jump on that and get all the value and the systemized tools to make this all actionable and make sure that you're mastering every single area of your life and accessing your purpose, your power, and your potential through your highest values, then you can join now. You'll get access to not only today's recording, you'll also get the previous 10 other masterclasses to set you up to win and access your limitless potential. So I hope this is of value. If you have any questions or comments or words of wisdom that you'd love to share, I absolutely love hearing from you guys. And definitely drop me a comment, say hi, and I can't wait to check in with you guys. So who have I got? I've got Mark and Sava and Guru, hello to you, and Filippo and Loki and Judy and Matthew. Good to see you. And Kyle is here. And Kyle, I literally am looking at Dr. DeMartini website and then pull up Facebook and this is the first video. That is so crazy. Oh my gosh. I love that, Kyle. We're in sync. I love it. And Greg's here as well, and Savula, and Joey, and Samia, and Loki. When it comes to the inevitable challenges, where do you draw the line when it comes to wanting to improve a perceived weakness that is outside of alignment with our highest purpose? Oh, I love this question, Loki. Oh, always. So what I would say to you is that when you know your highest values and you realize that, you know, you can have anything, but you can't have everything, and what you need to do is align fully with what matters most to you. And if you are kind of like, oh, there's a lot of challenge here and I'm wondering where to draw the line to like improve this weakness that's outside of my highest purpose, I'd ask yourself, what are you doing there? Like, what are you doing it for? Who are you doing it for? That's a really great question, because a lot of us are living to the expectations of others. And why do we do that? When we don't have clarity, when we're not, as DeMartini would say, turning up the voice and the wisdom, you know, in our internal world, and turning down the voices and judgments and expectations and opinions in our external world, when we're not doing that and we're doing the reverse, we end up subordinating to other people's perceptions, society's shoulds on what we should be doing, on people that are close to us, you know, our perceived expectations from them. And we don't have clarity and we're not sure where to draw that line until we get clarity and certainty and conviction within to know and have this kind of great filtering process to go, oh, that's totally not in alignment with who I am and what I want to be here for. And you can cut that stuff out despite the repercussions that you might experience in the external world. And I know that all too well when I made shifts and changes in my personal world as well. So alignment with our highest purpose. So I would think about that. Think about the reasons why you're doing it. And, you know, at the end of the day, you know, we are always, as human beings, to simplify how we work, we're always going to be doing things that we perceive to give us more benefits than drawbacks. And we're not going to do the things that we perceive give us more drawbacks than benefits. So there's some sort of payoff with any activity or action or inaction that we do or don't do, right? So if you can see, Loki, that this thing that you're considering, you're like, why am I doing this thing? Where do I draw the line here? And I'm perceiving it as a weakness. It's taking me away from, you know, my higher purpose. Then I'd ask yourself, what are the benefits that, you know, are keeping you in engaged in something that you know is out of alignment? You know, because guaranteed, if you're doing it, there's something there. And what you need to do is get clarity and make the mental shift within that goes, oh, there's too many drawbacks for me moving in this direction that's taking me out of alignment, and there's way more benefits in keeping in alignment with whatever that is. So that's a very general answer for a general question without knowing any more detail, Loki, but I really hope that that was of value to you. And as always, I so appreciate you tuning in and asking your questions, and I can't wait to hear from you after you get a chance to watch this month's monthly masterclass. So awesome. We missed your presence today. And Bina's here as well. Hello, beautiful. And Jamie, hello to you. And Kyle, do you know where to find his method? It's like a set of questions. Yeah, Kyle, so if you go on drdmartini.com and look at the values determination test, you might be able to Google it. Just put that in the search bar on his website, values determination test. It'll come straight up for you, and I highly recommend it. And I've done values work with many, many, many of the greats. And honestly, like, his is just the most straightforward and beneficial. Takes you out of this idealism and gets it into reality and looking at your actual life. So love that you're going to give that a go, Kyle. And let me know how you go. Oh, the DeMartini method. Oh, okay. So you're referring to the breakthrough experience, the DeMartini method. You can look at his book, The Breakthrough Experience. He has it outlined in there, although it's a little bit outdated. So yeah, the DeMartini method, I don't think that it's accessible just online unless you're reading his book and you've got the context, or you go to his event and you get the context, because it's very, very deep, and you kind of, it's very deep. So I do know, though, that you can get it from his book, The Breakthrough Experience. It's all outlined in there. So hope that helps. And Tommy's here as well. And Drew, awesome to see each and every one of you guys. I really hope that today's message has been of value. And you're definitely thinking about how important it is to identify your highest values, to see their attachment between, you know, your highest values and how that determines your purpose and gives you clarity on that. How you can, you know, make sure that you're accessing all of your power by nurturing and creating health in the eight vehicles of your potential: financial, mental, vocational, social, familial, relational, physical, and spiritual. You got to look at them all. And that will allow you to access your true potential, live to your whole potential in this lifetime, regret-free. And if you would like a system of doing all of that, that's exactly what was covered in this month's monthly masterclass with the Limitless Potential Academy, masterclass number 11, which was all about accessing your power and purpose through the eight vehicles of potential, all based on major lessons learned from spending 4 days at the Master Planning for Life event with Dr. DeMartini, and also his breakthrough experience. So hope that's of value. Reach out with any questions. Join the masterclass with the link above. Can't wait to go deep with you guys. And awesome, Kyle and Alex, hello. And Clyde, hello to you. Hope you guys who are catching me now will catch a recording, get a ton of value from today's message. I'm signing off. And as always, I'm sending you guys all of my love, light, blessings, gratitude, energy, enthusiasm, everything extraordinary coming to you to wherever you are in the world today. I really do hope that it's beautiful, amazing, and extraordinary, that you're doing something super empowering. And I hope that today's message has absolutely served you. I'm signing off. I'm sending you guys all of my love, and I cannot wait to see you again soon.